exercise experiment is estimation of percentage of calcium oxide in given sample of cement solution.
EDTA crystals, weight of EDTA plus weight of the weighing bottle W1 I am taking, it is 5.833, it is coming. Now I will be transferring this to funnel with this volumetric flask which is previously cleaned with distilled water. So then I will be taking the weight of weighing bottle alone, that is W2, that is coming 3.5 grams. So difference of this we need to take it. So now after addition of this, you need to add one test tube of, as usual, what you have observed in case of first experiment, that is total hardness of given sample of hard water. You need to add one test tube of ammonia and little distilled water, you need to add it. So then you need to add with this slowly and also with constant shaking in order to make the crystals completely dissolved. Once may ensuring that all crystals are dissolved, now you need to add distilled water up to this stem, and remaining portion you need to make it up with the help of burette. Fine. Here I have added the distilled water using this wash bottle. So then the remaining portion just below this, so that need to be added with the help of burette. Now it is made up to the mark. The lower meniscus should coincide to the line. Now you have to shake it well for uniform concentration by putting this stopper. Of this prepared standard solution to rinse the burette. Like this, this needs to be rinsed and it is to be rejected into sink. Now again this burette is to be filled with the prepared standard solution of disodium salt of EDTA. Slowly you have to add above zero because this nozzle portion is vacant, that need to be filled. Adjust the reading to zero. The lower meniscus should coincide to touch this zero mark on this burette graduation. Now I have here I have pipetted out 25 ml of cement solution into this. Then you need to add one test tube of a reagent containing 4 normal sodium hydroxide and 1:1 glycerol and diethyl ammon. All three reagents are added into it. It is made one solution. Instead of adding one each one test tube, we have made it blend of all these reagents, that is sodium hydroxide 4 normal, diethyl ammon and 1:1 glycerol. All is already added inside, and that one test tube I am adding. And you need to add 3 to 4 drops of pattern and Reader's indicator. Then you need to titrate it till this wine red color changes to clear blue. End point is wine red color changes to clear blue. When it is nearing to end point, you could see when the burette solution is added, you will be getting a little tinge of this blue coloration. So when it is appearing, slowly you need to add it just nearing to end point. Again, this is what the color, wine red color changing to clear blue. Okay, so you need to note down the reading. So here reading I am getting 6.8 ml. You just write it. Pass over. We got concordant titer value 6.8, and further calculation. 1000 cm cube of 1 molar EDTA is equal to 56.08 gram of calcium oxide, that is the molecular weight of calcium oxide. Then 6.8 ml of this molar EDTA contains how much? 56 multiplied by these two factors, that is 6.8 and molarity, volume into molarity divided by 1000. That gives the so much of grams of calcium oxide in 25 ml. So therefore 250 ml contains how much? Multiplied by 10. So then the weight of cement we dissolved here into 250 ml is 0.14. That solution we have taken. Okay, so we need to calculate the percentage of calcium oxide in given sample of cement solution. So by dividing this weight of calcium oxide present divided by weight of cement solution taken into 100, that gives the percentage. So 68.07% is the amount of calcium oxide present in the given cement sample solution. So this completes the calculation.